Tripod. In this little bit right here. There we go. Yeah. See. Ah, da, 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 da. Dum, da, dum, dum. Dum, dum. Let's see. Hey, we got some people on, right on. All right, let me see. I think I got all my settings. Good to go. Boom, boom. See who we have. No video feed yet. Who's an Auspatch? Let me see. Who do we have? Oh, hey! What's going on, Carlin? How you doing? Let me see. Who else do we have? Got a couple more blank screens. Oh, nice, nice, nice. We've got a couple more right on. We got a Chris. What's going on, Chris? Good to see you, man. Da, 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 da. Let me see. I think my oh, I'm still at an angle. Let me get straight here. Yep, I think I did it. Right on. Right on. We got some people. I don't know if you guys have the option, but definitely turn on your video if you can, because it'll be useful for me to be able to see you as we go through today's class. So, me see. What? There's a Zoe right on. We got a hundred. What? Got a Megan, hello. Let's see who else do we have here. Right on. Okay. What time is it? I'm gonna check the time real quick. Okay, it's 5 o'clock. So I'm gonna wait about one more minute just to see who comes in, and then we'll go ahead and get started. We don't really need anything crazy today. Just make sure you got some space. And I recommend a soft floor because occasionally we'll do things like sit-ups and push-ups, and there's nothing like doing those on a hardwood floor really quickly to make you wish you had a carpet or something. So just something to keep in mind. Right on. Oh, yes, we got Harper. Excellent. And we have somebody named Connecting to Audio. Ah, my favorite person. I'm kidding. They have a real name. I don't know who it is yet. Da-da-da-da. All right. Sweet. Okay, well, let's go and get this show on the road. So welcome, welcome, everybody. I'm super psyched to see you guys. I cannot tell you, I've been wanting to do regular classes so badly. I've been going nuts. So yeah, I'm psyched. This is gonna be an awesome time. We're gonna have fun. I got a great class plan. Thank you all for having your mics muted. At certain points during the class, I'll be asking you guys some questions, and when that time comes, you're more than welcome to unmute your mic so that you can chat. Just whenever I'm talking, keep yours muted and that kind of thing. Also, feel free to use the text chat, because I'll be checking that. So that way, if you have any questions but you don't want to interrupt the video feed, you can ask them that way, and that's totally fine. There might be technical difficulties. I don't know. I'm still kind of new to this whole Zoom thing, so. You know, if you need to interrupt things to let me know that, you know, I don't know, my eyes have switched spots with my mouth or something, then, you know, let me know. Okay, guys, let's get the show on the road. Give me a thumbs up if you're ready. Hey, we got a couple right on. Hop on your feet. Right leg in front. guarding stance. I'm going to shuffle forward, shuffle back, shuffle forward, shuffle back. That's it. Keep going. Let me see. Keep going. Keep going. Shuffle forward, shuffle back. Oh, goodness. Nice, nice. So now we're going to add into this. We shuffle forward, shuffle back, shuffle side, shuffle other side, shuffle forward, shuffle back, shuffle side, shuffle other side. Notice that when I shuffle side, I don't cross my feet like this. I always use a foot in such a way so that I don't cross myself, right? So I'm going forward, back, side to side. My guards are up. Exactly. Let's go and switch feet. Try it on the other side. Forward, back, side to side. Forward, back, side to side. Let me see. Keep going, keep going. Nice. Everybody's looking good. All right. So now what I'd like you guys to add, we're going to go forward, back, side to side on the forward. Whenever you go forward, I want you to jab, and then I want you to cross, and then jab one more time. Then back, side to side. Forward, that means jab, cross, jab. Back, side to side. Forward, jab, cross, jab. Back, side to side. Jab, cross, jab. Back, side to side. Over and over. Nice, let me see. Good, good, good. Mm-hmm. Nice, nice. Looking good. Nice, Blake. That's it. All right, so we've got our forward jab, cross jab, back. Whenever we get to our side, we're gonna duck. And then as we come up, we're gonna hook punch with our front hand. Notice my arm isn't super big and wide like I'm doing a giant haymaker. It's nice and tight, and I've got my hand like this so that I can hit something really close to me, right? So let's take it from the top. Step forward, jab, cross, jab, back. Side means duck and hook. Other side, jab, cross, jab, come back. Duck inside, hook, side. So it's the same footwork pattern from before. We're just adding some hands to it, right? Notice my timing. As I come to the side, I duck, and then as I come up, I unwind my body, and that's where my hook comes in. Jab, cross, jab, nice. All right, so next piece we're gonna add, I come forward, jab, cross, jab. As I come back, I'm gonna cover with my hands, like I'm making a big shield in front of my face, like this, and I'm gonna hit real low, and then I'm going to press forward with one shuffle, grab an imaginary bad guy, and do two knees. One, two. So again, I do forward, jab, cross, jab. Come back, cover, go low, come underneath, grab, knee, knee. Now it's side, duck, hook, side, jab, cross, jab. Back, cover, in, grab, knee, knee, side, hook. Coming out, let me see. Jab, cross, jab, coming back, cover. That's it, nice. Clinch and knees, beautiful. That's the one. And relax, so that's the pattern. What we're gonna do now is I want you guys to just do the footwork pattern by itself. We talked about three different things we can add. We have jab, cross, jab. We've got cover, clinch, and knee. And then we've got duck and hook. So I'm going to say randomly while you guys are doing this footwork pattern, either attack, knees, or duck. And that means that no matter where you're at in your footwork pattern, you have to make that work. So for instance, if I was doing my footwork pattern forward, back, side to side, and then I called out duck, even though I'm here, I have to duck and make my duck hook work. Then if I was here and Carlin called out attack, I'd have to go jab, cross, jab. If I was on the forward and Zoe called out knees, then I'd have to cover, duck, clinch, and knees. Does that make sense, guys? Give me a thumbs up. Sweet. All righty, guys. Start your footwork pattern. Go, go, go. Forward, back. Side, side, tap. Attack. Attack. Notice I'm not just calmly doing my technique. I'm doing it with some power now. We've got some reps. We know what we're doing. All right, knees. Cover. Clinch. Boost. Boost. That's the one. Keep the pattern going. Don't stop afterwards. That's the one. Attack. Knees. Duck. Attack. Knees. Duck. Attack. Duck. Attack. Knees. Attack. And time. Nice and done, guys. All right, everybody should be breathing a little bit by this point. I want to see 10 push-ups, 10 sit-ups, and 10 squats. Feel free to do varieties of your choice all in a row. Whenever you're done, hop into a horse stance that tells me you're done. Ready, set, go. Nice. So we've got those three extensions that we added from before. We named them attack, duck, and knees. What I want you to do now is I want you to create a flow out of them on your own. So what that means is you're trying to find ways to connect them. So what I mean is like I could do with you, trying to find ways to connect them. So what I mean is like I could do with. What's up? I heard somebody say something. I didn't understand it. What's up? I heard somebody say something. I didn't understand it.
What?
Oh, I'm hearing my voice echo back to me.
Your video is like delay. Your audio is delayed by 2 seconds, but we can hear you, or we can see you do something before you say it.
That's new. Okay. We'll work with it.
Why not?
Okay. All right, so anyways, keep it on going. Work with it. So I could do my jab, cross, jab, and then I'm gonna move right into my knees and then into my hook. That's the idea. I want you to mess with it, find ways to change it up. We're gonna go for about 1 minute, and I want you to just have some fun, give it some energy. Ready, set, go. And time, 10 more push-ups, 10 more sit-ups, 10 more squats. Check. How's everybody doing? Right on. All right, good work, guys. Let's do a quick stretch. Lacing the fingers, pulling them above the head. Three deep breaths in through the nose, out to the mouth. Down to the toes, nice and gentle. Four deep breaths. Nice, feet apart, going down to one side. Three deep breaths. Other side. Three deep breaths. Going down to a sumo stretch. Elbows in between my knees, looking up to the sky while I'm sitting down with my seat. Three deep breaths. Nice, going into a forward bow, hands in front of me, fingers laced. Two deep breaths. The hand that matches your back leg goes up high and we sink to stretch out the hip. Two deep breaths. High hand goes down low, stepping right beside the front foot, while the other hand goes straight above. Two deep breaths. And forward bow, other leg in front. Fingers laced, one straight in front of you. Two deep breaths. Nice, going down to the hip stretch, left hand in the sky, or if you're doing the other side, then it's right hand. And switch, two deep breaths. And relax. All right, guys, we're gonna take a minute for a quick water break. Go and grab something to drink. We'll continue.
We fixed our problem.
Oh, right on.
Yay.
Was it anything on my end or?
No, it was our end. We were broadcasting on the TV.
Oh, gotcha. Okay. Yeah. Well, I definitely blamed you from the start, so that works out well.
Yep. Not for us.
I'm kidding. It was Chris. I don't know if you were here for it, Chris, but I'm blaming you for technical difficulties, just so you know. Right on, guys. Let me make sure everybody's back. One thing I don't like about doing this, I'm doing this on my phone today because my webcam's busted, but I can only see four of you at one time, so I have to like pan and see everybody. There we go. Oh, hey, we have a Randy. What's going on, Randy? Nice, we have Cole. Excellent. All righty, guys. Review on our roundhouse kicks. I'd like to have, you know what? Let me see here. Who was here last time? I think Zoe. Ms. Zoe, would you mind turning on your mic and reviewing how we do a round kick with everybody? Everybody follow along with Ms. Zoe.
Okay. Basically, we talked about pivoting chambers, rechambers, and we talked about like going slowly and getting the maximum height, like stretching kind of your hips out. Yeah.
Nice. Yeah. So if you'll do it and have, so we can follow you. That'd be wonderful.
Here, hold on. I'm gonna tilt my camera down so you can see my feet, hopefully. Okay, there we go. So.
Nice. Do it in steps for us. Show us the pivot, then the chamber, then
pivot, kick. Chamber, kick, re-chamber.
Very nice. Everybody give Ms. Zoe invisible snaps. Thank you, ma'am. You're all good. So we're going to rep that. I'd like you to do 10 of those on each side. The way that we did it, that means you're doing steps. So I'm here. I pivot. I chamber. I kick. I re-chamber and I put it down. And I want to give each one a beat of time instead of just doing it pulling back. So my kick won't look like this. That would be more of a snap. I'm going to bring it up, hold, kick, hold, bring it back, hold, set it down. 10 times in each leg. Ready, steady, go. And time. Nicely done, guys. So now we're going to add a couple different variations of the round kick that's going to help build us. So far we've been doing lead leg round kicks. I'd like us to mess with rear leg. So I'm going to take my kicking leg and put it behind me. And what I'm going to do, all my stuff still applies, I'm going to pivot on the front foot. That means I'm going to turn my toes. If I'm using my right leg to kick, my left toes are going to be pointing to my left like this. That sets up my pivot so that my back leg can come through and kick, and I'm going to put it back where it came from. So I pivot, kick, put it back where it came from. I pivoted on my heel. I don't know how well you can see this. I pivoted on my heel. You can also pivot on your toes like this. Mess with both. See what you think. I'd like you to do 5 on each side at the same pace that we did last time. Rear leg kicks. Remember, the leg goes back where it came from after you're done. Ready to go. And remember to do both sides. Nice. If you've been doing these and holding the kick up for long enough, you should have a good burn near the IT bands on the sides of your legs. That means you're working those muscles and building that muscle memory. It's good stuff. Next variation we're gonna do is what I'm calling a cutting round kick. And basically what it is up until now, we've been stopping our round kicks at the target. That means if there's a bad guy in front of me, I kick him and I stop it there and I bring it back. Now we're gonna cut through like it's a big sword. So I'm going to pivot through as I kick until I land facing my original target with my other leg in front. So I'll show it to you from the side. I do my kick and I land. So I'm facing him with the other leg in front. Mess with that. I'm gonna give you guys about a minute. Try it on both legs. Ready, go. keep going, guys. I'm just going to watch for a second, make sure everybody's doing okay. Let's see. Nice. Oh, man. I've seen some high kicks, guys. Good job. Beautiful. Nice. Okay, so quick distinction I want to make sure everybody feels comfy with is on this one, there's two ways you could do this. One is where I do my kick in my rechamber here and then bring my leg back down. The other one is where I kick, cut through, and I don't rechamber until it's way past the target. That means that your cut, your draw on your leg is going to have a lot more penetration. It's not as safe, though. They might be able to catch your leg, but you get more power. Something to keep in mind. For about a minute now, what I'd like you guys to do is to work full speed round kicks. We've got three versions to mess with: lead leg, rear leg, and cutting. I'd like you to mix them. I'd like you to do both right and left sides and just have fun. Imagine an ugly bad guy standing in front of you and beat him until he's nothing but strawberry jello with your round kicks. 1 minute, have fun, go. I'm gonna watch, keep it up, guys. Remember to keep those guards up. And even if you have to kick low, make sure you get that good extension. Nice. Oh, sweet kick, Chris. I saw that, that was good. Nice. Oh, hey, Kylie. I didn't notice you. Let me see that kick again. Nice. Now that's a beautiful looking front kick. Show me a round kick. That's it. Beautiful. And time, guys. That's a round kick. Everybody go and take your mics off mute for a second. So I'm going to ask a couple questions here. Feel free to chime in. What is the most challenging part of round kicks for you? I just want to hear a couple opinions.
Balance.
I know you're like, I don't want to be the first one to talk.
It's the pivot. The pivot.
Nice. That I was expecting that. I was hoping that would be the answer. Pivots require a ridiculous amount of hip and angle dexterity, and they're going to be your hardest part. But in turn, they affect your round kick the most. They'll get you the most power out of all the mechanics going on in your body. That was an excellent thought, Zoe. Thank you. Give me one more.
Balance.
So one of the cool things about round kicks is they're harder to do slow. They're easier to do faster because of centripetal force. Whenever you get a spin going fast enough, the energy and the momentum of it will actually keep you balanced for you. So if you've ever seen like a top and spin a top, tops don't fall over till they slow down. It's the same thing with you. You're like a spinning top as long as you're doing that round kick nice and fast. So I don't know if you felt that whenever we did the two versions, slow and fast, but the fast one should have been easier for the balance. Thank you. Okay. Let's see. There was one more thing I wanted to ask. Don't remember what it was. That's okay. Thank you, guys. All right, go and put yourselves back on mute. We're going to move on to our techniques. So it's bear hugs today. Next Wednesday, if we have the time, if everyone feels comfy, I'm going to try to move us on to our punch techniques to try to catch us up to where we are in the module because we're a little behind for obvious reasons. So we'll see how well we do with it today. Level ones, you're up first with crashing wings. So what's happening is I've got a bad guy coming up from behind. He's bear hugging me around the belly. It's low, like around here, maybe the hips, but it's not past here because that's a different technique. The idea, if someone comes behind you and bear hugs you, they're most likely doing one of two things. One is they're holding you still for their buddy to come over and wallop you. And the other reason is they're trying to pick you up and slam you on something, right? And, oh, I just missed it. I just missed it, Hunter. Let me go back to the chat. I can see that again. Da, 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 da. Where is the chat? Chats. What are black belts doing phase? Oh, good question. You guys are doing phase one extensions. That's the last thing I heard from Sensei Milliken. He didn't tell me any different, so I'm gonna assume that it's still the case. So yeah, you guys will be doing this technique, crashing wings. So anyways, bad guys bear hugging him back here. There's two reasons they'll be doing it. One is to hold you still for their buddy, and the other one is to throw you. Either way, they're gonna try to keep you from moving, which means they'll be picking you up, they'll be kind of thrashing you around, or they'll be pulling you or pushing you, like taking you somewhere. So the first thing we need to do is get our stability. They've got me, my hands are gonna go straight in the air, and then I'm gonna hop into a horse stance. I like to do a double tap with my feet like this because it helps me feel a bit more grounded, a bit more quickly. You'll also sink faster whenever you're just letting gravity pull you down, which means if I let go of the earth with my feet like that, I'm actually gonna plummet a little bit faster. So give that a shot. Hands in the air and down. I wanna step out with my right leg rather than just landing where I am because I need to move off to the side. So I'm gonna come here. Elbows down. If you imagine a bad guy's arms around you, we'll pretend my arms are the bad guy's arms. I'm gonna bring my elbow down and dig the point of it into anything I can find. There's a bunch of good stuff. I can hit the radial nerve on the top here. That hurts plenty. The brachial plexus origin, brachial radialis is right here. That hurts lots. Really, it all hurts. I'm just trying to get the point of my elbow down and grind. Don't think hit, think grind. What that means is my elbows have to come in tight. I have to feel that my bicep is scraping and smearing down my chest. As I bring it down, once I'm there, I'm gonna grind it until the grip loosens. Whenever the grip loosens, I'm gonna bring my left leg to my right foot. So let's try that far. So hands in the air, they got us. I'm gonna step out to my horse. Elbows come down, grind, 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 and left leg comes together to the right. One more time. Hands in the air, stepping out to horse. Grind, 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 left comes together to the right. Now, they're behind me. I stepped off to their side a bit. I'm gonna use my left leg and step behind them. So now I'm kind of in a horse stance. They're right here in front of me. I've successfully gotten mostly behind them at this point. I'm gonna look at my watch. I'm gonna elbow them in the face. Then I'm gonna extend that same arm and hammer them. So I hit them twice with the same hand. It looks like this. I go elbow, hammer, elbow, hammer. So let's look at it from the top. They got us. Hands up. Horse. Grind. Step. Behind. Elbow. Hammer. Now my back hand is loaded. I'm going to pivot to a forward bow facing that way. And as I do, I'm going to smash them with the hammer right in the sternum. At this point, after my elbow, if I'm the bad guy and you just elbowed me, my head went like this. Then you hammer me again. So I'm further back like that. So your last hammer goes boom. They're going to fall down. It's a good time for us. So let's go through the whole thing. Here we go. Hands in the air, stepping out. Grind. Together. Step behind. Elbow. Hammer. Hammer. That's the one. All right, guys. On your own, I would like you to do that 5 times. That's everybody. Just because it's good for us all to know this. Ready to go. Beautiful. Nice and good stuff. Oh man, Kylie, you've got a righteous horse stance. Nice, Megan. That looks like it hurt. You see Harper. Boom. Wham. Beautiful. So, guys, if you do have partners, go ahead and work with them, right? If you've got like a family member around, even if they don't know anything, they're not martial artists, go ahead and ask them to come grab you, right? There's nothing wrong with that. If you don't have a partner, that's okay. But if you have them, go ahead and use them. Be nice on this part because the elbow points grind hurt. Ask them if they're okay with you trying it a little bit. And if they're not, then, you know, don't do it hard. But if they are, it is good to feel how that works for you. Once their grip loosens, that's when you're going to do the step together and then come behind. And from here, you'll feel that this just progressively knocks them down. And I'll give you guys a couple seconds on that. Nice, got a couple partners. Excellent. Thank you for helping, Cole. I appreciate it, man. Sweet. All righty, level twos, let's hit it. So level twos, it's a similar attack. This technique is called spiraling twig. And excuse me, I can't remember if I told you the name for the technique we just worked on. It's called crashing wings. That's the one we just did. So spiraling twig is next. This is for level twos. The attack's really similar, except instead of their hands being here, they're all the way up here, which means that I can't quite get my elbows down on top of their arms. So I can't do that anymore. Instead, I'm gonna step out to my horse just like before, and I'm gonna take my door knocker knuckles, these ones, and I'm gonna pound it like Tarzan, right where their hands are on my chest. And I like the pounding, but more than that, guys, I like grinding. I'll stick it in and I'll just like do this on their hand because these are sharp. And my goal is to just make it hurt enough so that their grip loosens. Like maybe they're holding on for dear life and then you're doing this and then all of a sudden they let go for a second to readjust. That's your shot, right? That's your window to get in. So as they're doing, or as you're doing this, their grip's gonna loosen at some point. When that happens, I immediately flap my hands down like I'm a chicken, right? Like this. I'm gonna flap my hands down like this. And what that's gonna do to their hands is, if these are the bad guy's hands, their hands are gonna go like this for a second. Whenever you flap that down, it's gonna pry their hands apart just a little. Even if it's not all the way, it's gonna help loosen where it was here. Maybe now it's here or something, right? So one more time, they've got us. My horse, first thing, tap, 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 tap. Flap once they're loosened. Any hand that I see, I prefer the right hand, I'm gonna grab it. Just that one hand. Let's do it again. Horse, tap, 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 flap. Take control. My left leg is gonna step, and tell you what, I'll turn around so this is easier to see. I'm here. My left leg is gonna step to my right, and then my right leg is going to step all the way around. That way I'm back facing them. So I'll show it to you from the side. If I was here and I did tap, 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 flap, I grab their hand, I step away to my right, and then my right leg comes behind me, so I'm now looking at them where they were. All I have to do is adjust my hands a little bit. So you'll see me go like this. That's me setting in a wrist lock. Their hand's gonna be like this. And I'm taking their hand and I'm making it go this way, towards their body. That's what I'm doing when I go like that. So keep that visual in your head as you're working it. And again, if you have a partner, feel free to use them. Let's rock it again. From the side view, horse stance, tap, 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 flap, take control, step, step. I'm now facing them, settle in the lock. Right leg front kicks them, and as I land, I'm gonna punch them. That's it, let's do it again. Tap, tap, tap. Flap, take control, step, step, lock, kick, and punch. That's spiraling twig. If you have any questions, go ahead and ask them. Otherwise, go ahead and practice on your own or with a partner. Ready, steady, go. Level ones, feel free to rep your technique, crashing wings. Level threes, especially like Randy, you need to know all of them, so practice all of them, right? Nice. Home. Send them flying, Tatum. Let's see. Nice. Uh-huh. Now, that's good, Carlin. Make sure you have a stance when you land, right? Because if I just do my front kick and then just sort of stand like this and punch, that's not going to do a whole lot. So what I do is I kick, and as I land, that's when I punch. I'm gonna land in that stance. Nice. You can also use the crush method on spiraling twigs. That sounds dramatic. I don't know what that is, but that sounds rad. Do you want to tell us? You can unmute and yeah. What is that?
Okay, so what that is, if my partner puts me in that thing, I can take my hands and sandwich his hands together, and that'll
open.
Yeah.
Nice, yeah, thank you, Hunter.
Yeah.
Actually, hold on. I don't know why I didn't think of this. Hunter, do you mind if I use you since you have a partner? That would be awesome. Can you guys stand back so we can see your whole body in the camera view?
Maybe I can try.
If it's possible. So all my level twos and level threes, I'd like you to watch these guys real quick. Level ones you can also. And I'd like you to, so you get the chance to see it done in a body, because Hunter is more than qualified to demonstrate here.
I don't know if I can get it to show her whole body. Let me try one more time.
Yeah, just do the best you can. If we can at least see the upper body, I'll take that.
Okay, it might just be the upper body.
Okay. That's not bad. I'll take it.
Okay. So he grabs, you want me to just do the crush part here? Okay. And then I'm going to take both my hands and I'm going to sandwich his hands together, and that'll kind of crush all of his arm and hands. And then I can go into the rest of my spiral twig.
Nice. Will you also show the first method, the tap, 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 so they can see both?
And then I'm going to be a gorilla and tap, tap, tap until I feel his hands loosen, come out, and go through my technique.
Excellent. Thank you, Hunter. Can I also ask you to show crashing wings so we can see it on the partner?
Okay, so he puts me in a bear hug. I'm going to step out. I'm going to drop down. I'm going to go around, elbow. Yeah.
Awesome. Thank you, Hunter. I appreciate it. So those are our techniques for level ones and level twos. Level threes, let's hit yours. Now, the cool thing is your level three technique is frankly probably easier than the level two one. So it should be easy for you guys to pick up. This is called crushing hammer. This time they've got my arms completely pinned. So before I had hands free, they've got us pinned now. What I'm gonna do is, as I step out into my horse, I'm gonna do it with my left leg this time. I step into my horse here, and I'm gonna use my hips to make space and turn this way from the side. This is what it looks like as I step. I'm gonna go like this. So there's a little bit of Elvis. What that's gonna do is create space. Now my hand is gonna have the room to do a little hammer fist to the groin. So if you guys remember doing captured twigs, it's a lot like that. As they've got me pinned, I'm gonna step out to horse and hit him in the groin. Now that I'm here, my right leg is gonna come together to my left. I'm gonna step behind them. It's very similar to crashing wings, except we're doing it on the other side and our hands are pinned. Let's do that from the top. So they've got us. I'm gonna step left into my horse, hammer the groin. Together with my right to my left, my right goes behind them, hit them in the groin again. Rechamber my hand. I might get incidental contact as this is rising. This might dink them in the chin. If it doesn't, it's okay. Then I'm gonna pivot to a forward bow facing my right leg as I turn my hand like this. And my goal is to hit them right here in the solar plexus. There's a spot where if you hit it, you should feel like you can push down at a 45 towards the ground, and it's going to make them have a seat. That's the idea. So I'm pushing not straight like this, but at an angle downward like this. You'll be tempted to go this way, but it'll just slip off their belly. So let's do it again. They've got us. I step out to my left, hammer the groin. Together, behind, hammer the groin again. Rechamber the right, pivot to my forward bow, and then palm down to the solar plexus. That's going to have them take a seat. Alrighty, guys, those are our three levels. I'd like everyone to practice your level. I'm going to give you about, tell you what, let's do it like this. I'd like you to do your technique five times, and then I'd like you to do five push-ups and just repeat that over and over. Ready, set, go. If you have any questions, feel free to go and turn on your mic and ask. That's just fine because I'm not going to be demonstrating anything right now. Ready to go. Oh, good question, Hunter. I need to pick up the extensions. I haven't had the chance to work with Sensei, but I should be able to have them by Wednesday. I forgot about it because I'll talk to him, have him send me footage. So don't worry, we'll have it next time. Thank you for asking. All right, let me see how everybody's doing. Remember, 5 repetitions, 5 push-ups, 5 repetitions, 5 push-ups. Peace and long life, am I right? The Vulcans knew what's up. Nice. And all my crashing wingers, remember, if I see that your elbows are wide apart like this, that's not where their forearms are. They need to come down here so that they're digging into their arms up here. If they come out to the side like this, you might be able to pry them apart just to moving their arm, but you're not getting the pain factor. And you want that pain factor. Yes, nice, Zoe, that looks great. And then let me see some of our spiraling twiggers. Do we have any spiraling twiggers? Nice. About 30 more seconds, guys, keep it up. Yeah, that looked good, Carlin. Home! Yeah, Tatum, bam! That's it, and time. All righty, guys, so we've talked about our bear hug techniques, and we also talked about roundhouse kicks quite a bit. At the beginning of class, we discussed several different attacking patterns. We talked about knees, talked about hook punches, we talked about jabs and crosses. So my challenge to you now is I want you guys to work your bear hug technique. Afterwards, I want you to creatively add a follow-up. So for instance, if I were here and a bad guy's got me and I'm doing crashing wings, then I do my technique, it's all normal here, but then after this, I add stuff. Maybe I do a round kick and I land with the hook and then I do cross jab. That's the idea. I want you guys to just add just 3 or 4 more hits afterwards and just have fun. Use your mind to visualize what you're doing and make it fun for yourself. We're going to go for about a minute. Ready, steady, go. Nice, Zoe, that looked great. Mm-hmm. Good, 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 good. What you up to, Chris? Can I see? Nice. Uh-huh. And let me see the follow-ups. Remember, we're adding follow-ups, Chris. So you're doing the technique, and then you're adding some punches, maybe some kicks, whatever you want to add. Boom. That's it. Nice. And relax, guys. Nice. So we normally don't do forms for the adults, but right now is a great time to know forms because they allow you to practice while you're at home. So we're going to go over what's called short form one in American Kenpo. This is really simple. You guys will be able to pick this up, no problem. But it's going to be a nice way for you guys to have something to do when you don't have access to a partner. It's just very obvious and very easy to follow. So let's do this together. We're going to start off with a salutation. Nice. Now I come out to my horse and I cover. This is where we're going to begin. This form follows a very easy pattern. We're going to start off and do inside block twice. My left leg steps back behind me into a guarding stance. My right hand does an inward block. My left hand shavers up against my ribs. So one more time from my cover, I'm here, stepping back, block. My right leg steps behind me. I'm gonna unwind. My right hand comes to my ribs and my left hand comes to an inward block. So you see, it's the same thing I did on the right side. Let's take it from the top. Cover, step back left, hammer chamber. Step back right, hammer chamber. I'll show you from the side. Cover, step back, hammer chamber. Step back, hammer chamber. From the other side. Step back, hammer, chamber. Step back, hammer, chamber. Nice, let's add the next bit. So I'm here at my cover. I step back, hammer, chamber. Step back, hammer, chamber. Right now my left hand is in front. My right leg is going to step together and then out to my right. I'm gonna turn and face my left. This is a 90 degree turn and I'm gonna do a vertical outside block. So it looks like this is my inward block. This is my vertical outside block. Somebody's coming to punch me from this direction and I'm blocking like that. That's the idea. I've still got my chamber. So I was here, my feet come together into my right and I turn and I block this guy over there. I'll do it from the other direction. So we're here, I did my first block. One, two, together, step to my right, turn and block. Left leg steps behind me. Unwind, now my right hand is a vertical outside. So this is the pattern. I'm just doing a block and I'm repeating it on both sides. I step back every time. We're gonna add the next piece and then I think we are out of time. So we'll call it there. So let's go ahead and add the next piece. Here we go. I'm here at my cover, stepping back, inward. Stepping back, inward. Together to the right, outward. Stepping back, outward. Now, and I'm gonna scooch this way, my right leg comes together to my left and then comes back where it came from. I'm gonna turn around and do a left hand upward block. Left foot comes behind me, unwind, and I do another upward block. So let's look at that transition again. I was here, I was at my outside, I step back, I do my right hand outside block. My right comes together and steps back out. I turn around, upward block, step back, upward block. That's the one. Let me watch you guys do that one transitional piece real quick. So we're at the outside blocks. Nice, looking good, excellent. Yeah, we can fit in the last piece, it's almost done. Okay, so let's take it from the top, we're here. Inside, inside, right steps out, left hand does outside, step back, right hand does outside, right steps together, steps out, left hand does upward, step back, right hand does upward. Nice. Now, my right leg steps towards my left and then steps behind me that way. I'm gonna unwind and do a downward block. So I'll turn and face you. This is what I'm doing, downward. Then I'm gonna step back with my right leg, unwind, and do a downward block. Let's take it from the top. We're here, inward, inward. Step and turn, outward. Excuse me, I'm gonna scoop so you guys can see. Outward, turn around, upward, upward. Right comes together, downward, downward. As I step back. Now, in order to get back to where I started, My left leg is just going to step to a horse, so I'm facing where I started. And I'm going to come my fist into my empty palm, come back to attention, and salutation. Nice, guys. So that is short form one. We're going to continue this on Wednesday. We're just about out of time, guys. I had a blast hanging out with all of you. Thank you so much. We're going to continue working this. If your bear hug techniques next week look good, then we're going to go ahead and hit our punch techniques and hopefully get caught back on track. Any questions before we go? Sweet. Thank you guys so much. Have a great night. We'll see you on Wednesday.
Wait.
Yes, sir.
One thing.
Yes.
Hi,
go ahead.
Everybody. Hi.
I'm listening.
Okay, I said hi.
Oh, gotcha. Hi. It's good to see you. All right, good night, guys.